Hello children, today's English class is from the Beehive textbook, The Sound of Music, Part 2, The Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. The lesson is all about Ustad Bismillah Khan. He was a renowned Shehnai player in India. He is a legend because he did something which has historical significance. He played the Shehnai on the day India got independence, that is on 15th August 1947 at the Red Fort before the Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, gave his speech. Before that, Bismillah Khan played the Shehnai in order to signify something auspicious for the whole country was about to happen. India was about to get freedom, and so on that occasion he played the Shehnai, a musical instrument, a wind musical instrument, and so he is a legend. Now children, have your textbooks open. When the lines are explained, you have to make the highlights and note down the meanings then and there. Make sure that you hear properly. Okay? Now the lesson starts with the first paragraph. Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in the royal residence of it, had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Now, Pungi was a musical instrument, the originator of the Shehnai, when the Mughal ruled India before the Britishers came. There was a very famous Mughal ruler named Aurangzeb, born in 1618. And died in 1707, the last great Mughal emperor. He did not allow the Pungi be played in his royal residence because he felt that it had a shrill means a very sharp, unpleasant sound. Now, Pungi became a generic name for reeded noisemakers. A name given to a class or a group as a whole means the scientific name or a broad classification of something. And reeded means wind instruments which have reeds in the flute or in the musical instrument like clarinet. So any musical instrument which is made with reeds, like we have flutes, clarinet, they all are classified as Pungi. So Pungi is a broad term for any type of instrument which uses wind to produce sound. Would you like to hear how Pungi sound is? So let's start. Okay, so that's how Pungi sound is. So as Aurangzeb has banged all these reeded noisemakers. He had banged Pungi in his royal residence. No one thought that one day such a noisemaker, such instrument which made unpleasant sound would be played and their sound would be liked by the audience. A barber of a family of professional musicians who had access to the royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the pungi. As the pungi had an unpleasant sound, there was a barber who belonged to a family of professional musicians and he wanted to play the pungi, but he knew that the sound produced by pungi was unpleasant, and so he decided to improve the sound. Tonal quality means sound. This barber took a pipe which was a hollow stem. It was longer and broader than the pungi. He made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. If you have seen a flute, it is something like this. It is a pipe which is hollow from inside and has holes on it. When he played on it, closing and opening some of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were produced. Do you want to hear how would it be? Okay, so that was the sound of Shehnai. So when the barber played this instrument in the royal court, everyone liked the sound produced by it. The royal court thought that this instrument was different from the pungi and so it should have a different name also. As the story goes, now there behind the name given to this instrument was played for the first time in royal residence of the Shah. Shah was a name given to the king. Mughals called the kings as Shah. As the Nai, that is, in the Indian term used for a barber, had played it for the first time, they called it Shehnai. So the first part is Sheh, which stands for Shah, and the second part Nai, that is a barber. So this instrument was named as Shehnai. Remember, Shah, which is Sheh, and Nai. Okay, Shehnai. The sound which was produced by Shehnai was considered to be good omen, and so it was played on good occasions. Auspicious means something which brings good fortune, good luck. And for this reason, it is played in temples. You hear this Shehnai even in weddings also. In the past, the Shehnai was a part of the Naubat. Naubat is an Urdu word and it means traditionally assembled. That means a traditional group of 9 musical instruments. These 9 musical instruments were played at the royal court, and Shehnai was also a part of Naubat. The Shehnai was played at the king's court, in temples and at weddings. It was used on stage in performance, and the credit for that goes to Ustad Bismillah Khan, who was a legendary Shehnai player, and people wanted to hear him play the Shehnai. Ustad means guru. Okay. When Bismillah Khan was 5 years old, he lived in an old estate named Damraun in present day Bihar state. He used to play Gilli Danda. Now we all know what is Gilli Danda, an old sport quite similar to cricket. And he would go to the nearby Bihari ji temple. Although Bismillah Khan was a Muslim, he would go to the temple and he would sing this song, Chaita, in Bhojpuri language. Bhojpuri language is spoken in an area of Bihar. When he would finish reciting the song, he would get a big laddu as reward. And the weight of that laddu was 1.25 kg. This was a prize given to Bismillah Khan by local Maharaj for singing the Chaita song. The writer says that this incident occurred when Bismillah was 5 years old, that he would get this laddu as a reward. And after 80 years, Bismillah Khan earned the highest civilian award in India, the Bharat Ratna. So this is the distance that he has travelled in his life. At 5 years of age, he would get a 1.25 kg laddu as a reward, and at 80, he received the highest civilian award in India, that is the Bharat Ratna Award. Now, Bismillah Khan ji also started learning at his age, early age. Bismillah Khan was born on 21st March 1916 in a family of musicians in Bihar. The family was a musician family. The lineage of his father's side was full of great Shehnai players. We can say that Bismillah Khan ji occurred in almost all the occasions. Acquired the skill of playing the shehnai from his ancestors. His grandfather was a great shehnai player. He played the shehnai in the court of Bhojpur king. His father and all paternal ancestors were also great shehnai player. So when he was young, he started learning in his early ages. When he was just 3 years old, his mother took him to her parents' house, to his maternal uncles. Maternal uncles means the lineage on one's mother's side. They lived in Banaras. Banaras is today called as Varanasi. And when Bismillah Khan saw his maternal uncle play the shehnai, he was attracted towards it and he also wanted to play it, play the shehnai. Soon Bismillah Khan started going with his uncle, Uncle Ali Bakhsh, to the Vishnu temple in Banaras. Ali Bakhsh was on a duty to play shehnai at Vishnu temple of Banaras. When Bismillah Khan saw his uncle Ali Bakhsh play the shehnai, he would get attracted towards it and he would sit there for hours, listening to him play the shehnai. Gradually, Bismillah Khan also started learning playing the shehnai and he would practice throughout the day. He never got tired. He was so captivated by the shehnai. For many years, Ustad Bismillah Khan remain in Banaras. He would visit the temple of Balaji, temple of Managlaya Maya, and would remain on the bank of river Ganga, where he would practice playing the shehnai all by himself. Solitude here means all by himself, being alone. Here we come to know about the talent of Ustad Bismillah Khan. He was so inspired and motivated by the river Ganga. It provoked him to improve his performance and he also invented many ragas that were considered impossible to be produced by a shehnai. He worked hard and invented different sounds with the shehnai. When Bismillah Khan was 14 year old, he accompanied his maternal uncle Ali Bakhsh to the Allahabad Music Conference. Ustad Fayaz Khan, he was a renowned classical vocalist, was impressed by his performance and said that if he would work hard like that, he would make a name in the field of music. When the All India Radio in Lucknow in the year 1938, Ustad Bismillah Khan started performing from there. Often his shehnai performance was on air. Ustad Bismillah Khan was the first Indian to greet the entire nation through his shehnai. He played the shehnai from the Red Fort on this memorable occasion. It is on 15th August 1947. the rag that was played by Ustad Bismillah Khan on the occasion of the independence of India was rag Kafi. He played it from the Red Fort. After his performance, the Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, gave his famous speech, Trias with Destiny. Bismillah Khan gave many performances in India and abroad. Some of them are memorable, like the one at Afghanistan. The King of Afghanistan, King Zakir Shah, really liked Bismillah Khan's performance and he gifted him many things which were made in Afghanistan, like Persian carpets, etc., so that he would remember his first visit abroad that was to Afghanistan. There were many other people also who were attracted to his Shehnai music. Goonj Uthi Shehnai was a name of a Hindi movie. It was made by Vijay Bhatt. He was a film director and he really liked the sound of the Shehnai played by Bismillah Khan. And that is why he named his movie as Goonj Uthi Shehnai. The film was a hit. There was a song in the movie Goonj Uthi Shehnai named Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya. It was composed by Ustad Bismillah Khan and became a chartbuster, a record breaker. Although this song was a chartbuster, Bismillah Khan got a lot of success in this film, but he composed music for only two films. The names of the movie were Goonj Uthi Shehnai, made by Vijay Bhatt, and a Kannada music made by Vikram Srinivas called Sannadi Apna. Ustad Bismillah Khan played a music that I'm going to play for you now. Just have few seconds of it. Okay, so that was the music played. He would say that he did not like the artificial world of films and the glamour that was there in the film world. That was why he did not compose music for many movies. He got a lot of recognition and was honored with awards. Bismillah ji performed all over the world. He performed in United States of America at the Lincoln Center Hall. He performed in Montreal, Australia in the World Exposition. He performed at the Cannes Art Festival and he also performed in Japan at the Osaka Trade Fair. Tehran is located in Iran. Bismillah Khan was so famous all over the world that Tehran, an auditorium, has been named after him. Tahar Mosiki Ustad Bismillah Khan. He has in his life been awarded with many national awards like Padma Shri Award, Padma Bhushan Award, Padma Vibhushan Award. When Ustad Bismillah Khan received India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna Award, in the year 2001, which is 2001, his eyes were shining. He was very happy because his hard work had been recognized and he gave an important message to the world. He told all the Indians to teach music to their children because music is the richest tradition of India. He said that even the Western countries wanted to learn Indian music, our music. Although Ustad Bismillah Khan ji had travelled all over the world, he was given so much respect and recognition. He remained rooted in Banaras where he learned music and Dumraon where he was born and brought up were the two most important towns of the world for him. He was so down to earth that although he had travelled all over the world, still he was attached to his birthplace. There was a student of Bismillah Khan and he wanted that Ustad ji should set an Shehnai school in USA. He promised that he would recreate the temple of Banaras in America for Ustad ji as he would miss it. Now Ustad ji was so attached to River Ganga also, so he asked his student that he would be transport the River Ganga also to America. So he wanted to say that he could not leave India. He was attached not only to the temples of Banaras but also to the holy river Ganga. Ustad Bismillah Khan said that whenever he visited any foreign country, he longed to see India. He wanted to return to India. And then he says that when he was in India, in Mumbai, he yearned to visit Banaras and the river Ganga. And when he was in Banaras, he missed his birthplace Dumraon and the Mata where he sang Chaita song and was rewarded with the Laddu of 1.25 kg weight of it by the Maharaja. Now here the writer says that Ustad Bismillah Khan was so perfect example of rich culture heritage of India. His work was beyond the religious barrier. Although he was a strict Muslim, he followed the Muslim laws, but every morning he would play the Shehnai at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. Which was a Hindu temple. This shows that he did not have the barriers of religion in his mind. He was a true Indian. He considered music to be India's richest cultural heritage. Ustad ji passed away on 21st August 2006 at an age of 90 after a prolonged illness. He was given a state funeral and the government of India declared one day of national mourning. There was a holiday for one day and he was given a state funeral. So that was about Ustad Bismillah Khan. He was a renowned Shehnai player. Now very fast I'll summarize the whole lesson so that you get the complete idea of it. Ustad Bismillah Khan made a valuable contribution to the world of music through the Shehnai. For this he was honored with India's highest civilian honor, the Bharat Ratna Award in 2001. He hailed from a family of musicians. He improvised many new ragas with the Shehnai and thus played it among all other classical musical instruments. He won accolades on the international level too. The Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of the pungi in his royal court. He disliked the sound and so the pungi was termed to be a noisemaker. A barber tried to improvise the pungi stone. He got a hollow stem wider and longer than the pungi, made 7 holes on it and blew into it, closing and opening the holes. It produced soft, melodious music. As this instrument had been developed by a barber called Nai in India and was played in the king's court called Shah, the instrument was named Shehnai. The Shehnai became a part of auspicious occasion. It was a part of the group of Naubat, 9 instrument, musical instruments that were played at the royal court. Now, Bismillah Khan was born at Damron, Bihar in 1916 into a family of musicians. His father, Rasul Bakhsh Khan, played the Shehnai at the court of the king of Bhojpur. His father, Paigambar Bakhsh, and his paternal uncle as well as maternal uncles were Shehnai players. As a child, Bismillah Khan would visit the Biharji temple to sing the Bhojpuri Chaita, for which the king rewarded him with a laddu weighing 1.25 kg. At the age of 3, Bismillah Khan visited his maternal uncle Ali Bakhsh at Banaras. He saw him playing the Shehnai and was fascinated by it. At the age of 5, he started learning playing it. He would spend hours practicing in the temple of Balaji and Mangalya Maya by the banks of the holy river Ganga. The flowing water of the river inspired him to improvise and he invented new ragas which were considered to be beyond the range of the Shehnai. At an age of 14, he performed at the Allahabad Music Conference and his talent was appreciated by Ustad Fayaz Khan. In 1938, he started performing from the Lucknow station of the All India Radio. The day India gained independence on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan performed from the Red Fort and greeted the country through his shehnai. He recited Raag Kafi, which was followed by the Prime Minister's famous speech. Bismillah Khan performed all around the world. His first foreign performance was in Afghanistan, where the king was so impressed that he gifted him many souvenirs. Bismillah Khan composed music for two films, Hindi film titled Goonj Uthi Shehnai, directed by Vijay Bhatt, and Kannada film titled Sanadi Apna by Vikram Srinivas. He was the first Indian to perform at the Lincoln Center Hall in the United States of America. He also performed at Montreal, Cannes, and Tokyo. In Tehran, an auditorium was named after him, Tahar Mosiki Ustad Bismillah Khan. He said that music was India's richest heritage and had to be taught to the children. Although he had travelled all over the world, he was attached to Damron at Banaras. Once a student asked him to set up a Shehnai school in the US and promised to recreate the temples of Banaras there. Bismillah Khan asked him whether he would transport the river Ganga also, as he was attached to it as well. Now, Bismillah Khan is a true example of a secular India. As being a Muslim, he played the Shehnai at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. For him, music was above religious barrier. I hope you would have understood the lesson. I have given some question answers. Go through those question answers. I want everybody to read the lesson thoroughly, note the meanings then and there, so that you can understand the lesson better. You can watch the video again and again until you understand the complete lesson. Make sure that you complete the assignment and send it to my email ID. If you have any doubts regarding any paragraph in the lesson, you can call me or you can text your question to my number. I hope you would have understood this lesson. Complete the assignment and send it to me. Okay? Take care. Bye, children.